turbo installe. So this is my Plymouth Sundance. Very beautiful car. Lovely, lovely. And these are the things I need to do to install my turbocharger from a Evo 8. Should do just fine. And I think I'm gonna get the most annoying stuff out of the way first. First being fuel pump. So Chrysler made it nice and easy to change this fuel pump by requiring you to drop the tank. So that's nice of them to do that. So I know for an absolute fact that the stock fuel pump in this car is not gonna be able to supply the amount of fuel I need. So I'm not even gonna bother trying to use it, which is why I bought this AM high flow intake fuel pump. It's a popular choice. It flows, I don't know, like enough fuel for 600 horsepower or something crazy. More than we're ever gonna make. Right, so if my calculations are correct, when I turn the fuel pump on, the fuel should go in there.
Yep.
There it goes. What's that thing bar tenders do? They go really far away. I like when you piss really far away from the urinal. This really isn't great to do to your fuel pump, but if you're replacing it anyway, what's the harm? Right, so this might be interesting. So I need to like break off this plastic and somehow mount the AEM pump here. Probably use a hose clamp and attach it to this. Looks like a fuel line, but it's just a reinforcement to keep everything stiff. So I'm just gonna start breaking this apart. Not too shabby, if I do say so myself. Let's put this thing back in there. Fuel pump. Done. All right. So what else do we got? I guess the next thing to do is mount the turbo. So I have to make some flanges, modify the exhaust to make it exhaust. So this is our turbo. It's the 9.8T from the Mitsubishi Evo 8. That's a 2-liter car. This is a 2.2 liter. However, this one doesn't spin as fast as the Evo engine. So these engines don't like to make power past like five and a half grand. So I wanted something a little bit smaller that's gonna spool up quickly so I can actually make some low end torque. And I think this is gonna work just fine. So I've gotta make some adapters to adapt this to my headers and get everything situated and mounted. This is gonna be the most difficult part of the whole job. So I took my headers off and the welds on this thing are very custom. So I have my turbo here and I need to remove this flange and put on this flange. This is actually a twin scroll turbo, which basically means it spools faster, makes more power. Always a good thing. So I need to connect two of the runners to one hole and the other two to this hole. So I've been working on the headers and I have to make them really compact because since it's a reverse flow head, turbo sits way down here. And in order to get the turbo in with the intake manifold, exhaust manifold on, I have to remove the crankshaft pulley and the power steering pump, fish it up through to get it back there. So it's a little bit more difficult than it normally would be. And my headers are there. They look a little bit Mad Max-ish. Hey, future me here. So I made a big mistake when designing the headers that I barely realized after putting everything together. So with a dual scroll turbo and a four cylinder engine with a 1-3-4-2 firing order, you want cylinders 1 and 3 going into one hole and 2 and 4 going to the other. Whereas here I have 1 and 2 going into one hole, 3 and 4 into the other, which basically means that the twin scroll turbo is going to act more like a single scroll, which isn't that big of a deal. It still works, but that's going to bother me until I fix it.
Mad Max-ish, and they're not the best exactly for flow, but I'm doing the best with the tools I have at hand. I don't have a machine shop or anything on me, so it'll work. And I'm welding the mounting surface because while I was welding it, the plate flexed because it got too hot. And so I'm welding this one, and then I'm gonna use the flap disc to grind them down. Okay, so in order to clock this turbo that is not meant to be clocked, I have to grind away this dowel pin with the Dremel very, very carefully. If I slip up even once, this housing is donezo. Gotta get a new one. Gotta insert drama somewhere. That is a grinded dowel pin. That should work. Okay, so I've got the turbo in there and it fits like an absolute glove. It looks absolutely beautiful in there. So next thing I need to do is take the oil pan off, drill a hole in it for my oil return. Right, so I went ahead and welded my little bung on. Wanted to go ahead and weld it to the pan just because there's no way a weld is ever gonna come loose or leak. And if that happens, well, obviously you have to take your pan off all over again, and I don't wanna do that.
Interesting weather. It's like God is descending. Oh, or he's angry, either or.
I made a dick! It's also a downpipe. So it looks a little bit ugly and Mad Max-ish, but considering what I made it with, I don't feel bad. So that'll just shove right in there like that. And I put a V-band on it so I can easily convert it to a 3-inch exhaust at some point. So that's good. Got the headers bolted on. I put some heat wrap on them. You can't even see it. But anyway, so starting to bolt stuff back together. Still need to make the intake. Get the return line on, route the feed line. I'm getting close. So these are the links I had to go to serpentine the intake charge where it needs to be. I had to use a smaller diameter pipe that turns into a 2.5-inch just because there wasn't room for the 2.5-inch way up in there. Having the turbo way on the back of the engine is just, yeah, okay. So it should start, hopefully. We'll see. Oh, I hope this doesn't blow up or do something stupid. That would suck. Come on now. I smell raw fuel, so it's definitely an ignition issue for some reason. Okay, the car runs. So all of this crap is done. So all we have left on this board is knock sensors, fuel injectors, and transmission. So knock sensors I've already got taken care of mostly. I've just got to wire them up. I think I'm going to use the ones that came with the car. And fuel injectors, currently I have injectors from like a 2003 SRT4. They're like 450 cc's. So depending on how much power we end up wanting to make, we may have to change those. And transmission, I already have a manual transmission. So the 3-speed auto in that car can only take like 200 horsepower, which is definitely less than what we're planning on making. So manual swap is gonna happen. So I have my computer apart here, and the Mega Squirt manual recommends that I use one of these. It's from an 80s Ford or something. I didn't have the pigtail, so I soldered some wires to it. And I need to solder some transistors and diodes and do some stuff. Don't really know what the point is, I'm just following orders. Right, so with the automatic transmission and no knock sensors set up, I'm running safe timing and low boost, about 9 PSI. So I'm gonna run down the 8th mile, see what it'll do, and I'm gonna lift between shifts in an attempt to prevent the transmission from grenading itself. But we'll see what happens. Right, so our first time was 13.2, and if you convert that to a quarter mile time, which is a language most people speak, 20 and a half seconds. That is slow. And if we compare that to our turbocharged run, it's 15.9 seconds. So about 5 seconds basically off of our quarter mile time, roughly. You know, the conversion isn't 100% accurate, but that's still like that's a huge improvement. And if we look at our data log here, this line is our air fuel ratio, and it's kind of all over the place. So right here it's like 9, here it's in like the 12 range. And if I took a little bit more time to tune the air fuel ratio better, definitely could have gotten a better time. But basically my goal for this video was to put the turbo on, make a little bit of boost, and call it a day. And I think that's exactly what I did. So when I get the manual swap done, I'm going to turn up the boost to about 19 PSI. We're going to basically double it. So we're going to go a lot faster than this.